Irish Setter. The Irish Setter is an outgoing, restless and mischievous breed, which originated as a hunting dog in Ireland. Shortly it became truly popular because of its prodigious red coat and excellent hunting talents. This breed is an extrovert, always ready to play with other dog or its owner, and will make both as great hunting dog and an excellent family companion. The Irish Setter was initially a variation of the Irish Red and White Setter, and it appeared in Ireland and in the United Kingdom in the 18th century. In Gaelic it was named as Red Dog. In creation of the Irish Setter took part a number of the breeds, including the Irish Terrier, Irish Water Spaniel, Ingles Setter, Pointer and the Gordon Setter. Primarily the dog had a name of the Irish Red Setter, which is today simplified to the Irish Setter. In the 19th century the breeders started purposefully breeding the Irish Setter with coloration of solid and rich mahogany. The trend for this color of setters was established by the Irish Earl of Enniskillen, who in 1812 kept exclusively red type of the setter in his kennels. Prior to 1862 the Irish Setter served only as a hunting dog. It is renowned for its versatility and can work as a pointing dog, a scent dog, and a retriever. The hunters who like to hunt on their own or couldn't afford to have many dogs preferred this breed over the others. The 1862 was marked with the birth of Champion Palmerston, the Irish Setter, which determined the standard for the modern breed. It was bigger and bonier with more clearly outlined muzzle than other specimens of the breed at that time. The vast majority of the today's Irish Setters are somehow related to Champion Palmerston, and its traits can be obviously recognized in the breed description of the modern days. In 1875 the Irish Setter was brought to America, and in no time it became amazingly popular there as the family companion as well as the show dog. Gradually the breed members have been divided into two types, the show type, which is called the Irish Setter, and the working gun dog with the name of the Red Setter. The American Kennel Club, AKC, gave recognition to the breed in 1878. The popularity of the Irish Setter in the USA spiked in the 1960s and 1970s due to the books and films featuring a big red, the Irish Setter star. Nowadays it's less fashionable than previously, but it remains one of the most recognizable breeds in America and in Europe. The Irish Setter is a dog with bright individuality, rollicking and energetic. It offers a well-balanced combination of independent character and loyalty to its master. The breed is apartment to develop a tight bond with every member of the family. The Irish Setter is great with children and is going to become a willing playmate for them. It will put up with substantial roughness in the game, but it's more suitable for home with older children since it's too boisterous for a toddler. The Irish Setter easily lets new people in its life and most of the time will be amicable with strangers. Though it should learn the proper manner, since it tends to welcome newcomers in your house by jumping and knocking them over in attempt to kiss. This breed can be turned into reasonable watchdog, which will notify the owner about approach of a stranger. But it's going to be poor guard dog as it's deprived of natural aggressiveness to excel in this job. It hasn't been noticed that the Irish Setter has some considerable issues with other dogs. Actually it prefers to live with minimum one canine, but the more the better. The fellow dog should also be vigorous and active so the Irish Setter won't bother it in attempt to play. Under condition of sufficient socialization the breed will be friendly with strange dogs and non-canine home pets. The setter shouldn't attack and hurt the prey during the hunt and only barks to detain it. That's why it will get along with a home cat and other small animals. Some dogs tend to harass cats, but only in an attempt to drag it in the game. The attendance of the Irish Setter requires considerable amount of efforts. The coat of the dog is prone to mating and tangling, so it should be carefully brushed every day. It also needs regular trimming, which can be done by the owner himself. Majority of the owners prefer to take their dogs to the professional groomer every 6 to 8 weeks. The Irish Setter is not particularly heavy shedder, but it does shed. The breed isn't recommended for the individuals who are not capable to put up with tons of hair on their clothing and furniture, or who are just allergic to dogs' hair. A special care requires the ears of the Irish Setter, which attract debris and dirt. They must be cleaned regularly to prevent the irritation and infection from happening. As a hunting dog, the Irish Setter is exigent to amount of physical activity. The master should walk with the dog at least for an hour every day, but it should also get a chance to roam around on the territory with high fence. Your dog will gladly accept any strenuous exercise in a form of work or game you can offer it. This breed will make a wonderful hiking or jogging companion. The Irish Setter, which has not enough outlets for its exuberant energy, is predisposed to turn into nervous, destructive, overexcited animal with a nasty habit of ongoing barking.